So again, I'm using a piece of paper put underneath my needles, and it is a combination of 12 stitches. I'm going to be moving the third and fourth needle, the ninth and tenth needle out of that section of 12. Of course, you could always put a bobby pin or some other marker on the stitch below the needle, but I find using this paper a little bit easier. So this pattern is a combination of 6 rows. As you see, I have my waist yarn on. I e-wrap with my main yarn. I did not use ravel cord this time because this yarn here, I could just snip it. Actually, it'd be over here. And I could pull that last row out and throw away that ending part of the waist yarn. So first of all, I want to knit one row. Actually, I do want to keep that Russell lever out because I am going to mark again like I did before with tuck stitches. So I've got needles 3 and 9. I only need to tuck those, but I know I'm going to have to do needle 3 and 4 and 9 and 10. So now I'm going to knit 5 more rows. Then, oops, as I look at the fabric, of course I could see 3 right here on the first row is no problem, but I could take that stitch there, if I can get it, and then the one next to it, and I want to put it on needles 5 and 6. So I go 9 and 10. Move those over to needles, or hang them on needles 11 and 12. Again, 3 and 4. Maybe I should do 4 first. And go over to 5 and 6. 9 and 10. Hang those on 11 and 12. Now, I'm going to bring those needles out to hold position, only because I do want those to knit a little bit more properly. I'm going to hang claw weights on the end here. I'm going to knit one row across. And again, I'm going to take needles 3, 9, 3, and 9. Of course, depending if you have the whole bed, you're going to have a longer paper or you're going to mark the stitches below that. Knit to row 12. Again, I look. I have it right here, so 3 and 4. Now, the other thing you could do is you can go and count down. If you don't have the tuck stitch there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this time I'm going to go over to needles 1 and 2. 9 and 10. Okay, there's that one there. Go over to 7 and 8. 3 and 4. Maybe I should do 8 rows instead of 6 rows. I'm going to try that on the next one. 9 and 10. Back over to 7 and 8. So I knit one row across. Again, I'm going to take those needles that I need to mark with a tuck stitch in order to transfer to the next stitches. So let's see, that was 1, 2. That would be 6 rows. Actually, it's not really that bad. If you want to try 8 rows, you can go ahead with that. So again, I look down here, and it's going to be right above where I did the last tuck there. And I'm going to go back to the right, 5 and 6. To the right, 11 and 12. Suppose I could pull them out as I hang them. Five and six. Eleven and 12. Knit one row across. Bring those needles out that I need to mark with a tuck stitch. Knit back. Oops, I did one row extra than I was supposed to. I could go ahead and undo this, but let me do, I did the first three with six rows, now I'm going to do the next three with eight rows. Just so I could show you what it looks like. So three and four, I went to the left, so now I got to go to the right. I'm sorry, went to the right, now I got to go to the left. And if you look at the fabric, you can see how it goes right, left, right, and that's how I know I got to go to the left. But having my marks here, I probably should have changed those numbers on the paper a different color. To see easier, I just took a pencil and circled them. I actually had to knit one more row. I had to knit back that one last row. So to do eight rows, I reset my counter so I know what I'm doing here. So again, as before, I'm moving the needles out to mark, because I have the right wrestle lever here out. It's going to make a tuck on these stitches. But when I go back, it's going to knit it. So here it is. Now you do have a little bit of a wave going down here with the six rows. You have more of a wave with the eight rows. It's really up to you. This is very faint, but it's still going to show up. This one here is going to show up a little bit better. So before you go and add this to a garment, you probably want to do a little swatch, figure out if you want the six or eight rows, and see how it works out for you.